Hi guys, my name is Fruity and I created a beautiful tutorial on the Divi theme. And in that Divi theme tutorial, I'll show people how to create a website from scratch using the Divi theme, but not everybody wants to have a portfolio in their website. So I created a separate tutorial on how to create a portfolio in your own website using the Divi theme. And in this video, I will show you step by step how it is done. And then I would like to say, let's get started. In the original Divi tutorial, I'll show you how to create a website like this, exactly like this one. I will show you step by step how to create this and show you how to work with the Divi theme. If you want to follow that tutorial and start from scratch, you can go to fruitycorp.com, then hover over tutorials, Divi, and then you can watch this tutorial. And if you want to follow along with the same images I use in this tutorial, then scroll down and click on download the images I use in the tutorial. Then you can unzip them and bring them to the desktop if you want to. I close this. In order to create portfolio items on the portfolio page, I go to the portfolio page. If you don't have that page, you can hover over new, click on page. I type in portfolio, publish it, and then you can go to appearance, menus. And then you can get the page and add it to the menu like that. You save it and then you have it in the menu. So I go to the website, I don't save this. And then I go to the portfolio page. And here I want to create a portfolio. How can I do that? Well, I need to start with a first portfolio item. And the great thing is Divi has that built in, so we can create a portfolio or project. I click on it. And now we can add a title. Well, this is a portfolio item for me of the wedding of Daniel and Leah. So I say wedding Daniel and Leah. If I publish it, I publish it. We can view the project. I hold command so it opens in a new tab. And this is everything how it looks. I don't like it. So what I want to do, I want to enable the Divi builder. So I click on it. And now we can create a portfolio item. I want to start from scratch. And then I close this. I click on the blue plus. And I want to go for a regular area, one row, and then I search for a text. And here I say, wedding Daniel and Leah. I select it, make this a heading one. Then I go to design. I want to bring this to the middle, so text. Let me see, make it capitals. Bring it to the center and make the text light. Then you don't see it anymore, but I want to change the background. I hover over here, this upper area, I want to remove it. And here I click on the settings. I go to background, gradient, add a background gradient. And here you can select the color. I have the colors already, the first one and the second one. Then I want to change the gradient direction to 90 and the starting position 2 and the end 70. Okay, check. I go to the text over here, design, heading text, H1, and I want to make it bigger, like that. What I can do now, I can save this area as a template, so I can import it. I don't have to make it for every portfolio item again. So I click over here, and I save it as portfolio header or heading. I can add it to a category, headers, and save it to the library. And for the next portfolio item, I can import this really easily. Then over here, I want to add images. So I click on the plus, I add a regular section with one row, and I search for gallery. I click on it, and then I click on add gallery images. I want to upload them, select files, images, tutorial, portfolio, photography, Daniel and Leah. And what you see over here, family shoot Westland, group shoot Westland. I renamed them all so I can be found better in Google. So if I search for family shoot Westland, I go to images. This is mine. This is mine. This one. So a lot of images here are mine. And why is that? Because I called this family shoot Westlands, so I will be found on that. So it's important to rename your files. Otherwise, if you search for IMG0001, you go to images, you also find those images. Why? Because they did not rename them. And people do not search for this when they search for a photographer in the Netherlands. So rename your files to something that's relevant to the service that you have to offer. So I click on select files again, portfolio, photography, Daniel Lea. Over here, I click and then command A. So I select them all or control A on the PC, open them, and they will be uploaded. Well, if you want to optimize them, click over here, remove the dash, copy the title and paste it at the alt text, and do that with every single image. You only have to do it once, and then your image is optimized. So I select them all. There they are. I can change the order, and now they will appear over here. Well, honestly, I don't like the way they are displayed. So I can go to the image order. I can say default. I can say random. I can change the image count. Right now, they show only 4 images. I want to show 20. So you see them all. I don't want to have this text. So let me go through the settings. I go to elements, show the title and caption. No. Show pagination. No. Because I show them all in one page. How about linking? Link to the same window. So if you click on it, it will probably open as a lightbox. We can take a look at the background, but I want to remove that. I don't need a background. And then we can go to design, layout. Do we want it to be a grid or a slider? You can also have a slider, but I prefer the grid. Then the thumbnail, orientation, landscape, or portray. So it will be standing images. I think I like it, but I prefer landscape. Overlay, when you hover over it, what should happen? Well, personally, I think, you know, a little bit like this, but then a lot of transparency. Let me see what's happening. Oh, that's the icon color, the overlay background color. I copy this, make it white, and then here I paste it. So like that. You can have an icon. I prefer not to have an icon, so I make this totally transparent, and then you only see an overlay. Image. We can have a border. Like that. In this color. Why not? Should be solid or a groove, so you can change the style of the border. Of course, you can change the images, but I see no reason why you should do that. But it's possible. And then let's go, let me see, to the sizing. That's okay. And I collapse this. And then I want to go to transform. And I want to make it a bit bigger. So if I would say 103, turn it up like that. I like that. Or 100. Then I can go to the settings of the row. I go to design, sizing, change this to nothing or to 2. Equal column heights if we want to. We can change the width. I like to say 100%. And the max width, we can make it like this. And then I would like to bring the gutter to 1. Okay. And the spacing, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, everything 0. I don't like the gap over here. So let me see, maybe here at spacing also everything 0. Perfect. I like that. Command S. Then I want to have this area again over here. So I click on the plus add from library header. And I make this a little bit less high, but first I want to change this to related projects. I want to make it smaller, the text. So I go to design, heading text. I think it's H1. I should change it to H2. So let me see. Yes, H2. Then I go to design, heading text, H2, regular. Make it white, of course. And I think this is fine. And then I go over here. Spacing 0, 0, 0. So it's not that big. And then over here, a new area. Regular one row. And then I go for the portfolio. Post only 4, or you know what, 3. Not all categories, only the current category. So the category that he sees over here will be also be shown. And you see the wedding of Daniel and Leah. I want a 3. If I go to design layout, it can be a grid. If I go to content again, let me see. Content, post count, 3 elements. Show title, show categories, no. Show pagination, no. Okay, like this. I save it. But we don't see an image over here. So how can I fix that? I click on edit project. Then over here, I go to the featured image, set featured image, and I choose an image. I like this one. Update. So view the project. Wedding Daniel and Leah. With a nice light box. Beautiful. And related projects, and then we see the same project. This can be bigger, so I click on enable visual builder. Scroll down. So let me see over here. I click on the row settings, design, sizing. Make this 2. Or not. Make it 1. Then I click over here. And the design. Let me see the text. I want it to be in the center. Perfect. And when I hover over it, overlay, again, I want to say at the color, nothing. And at the overlay of the background, I want to have this one, but a lot more transparent. Like that. Come on, Des. But what I want to do now, I want to save this page as a template. So I click over here and I save this as a project template. Save it to the library. Okay, one more thing. I go to edit project and I want to create a category. Well, this is photography. I offer 3 services. I go to categories and I create a new category, which is photography. Add a new one. You can have subcategories again. I don't want that. Update. Now I hover over new. I go to project. And I go for the Montana Lisianthus project. It's not photography, but it's film. So I add a new category. I call this film. Add the category. Then I go for a featured image. Upload files. Add portfolio. Film. Montana. Open, optimize, paste it, set as featured image. Then I click on publish, publish, and then I click on use the Divi builder. And I click on choose a page. And I can say I want to choose this one. Now we can change the settings. What I can do now, I can change the text every time I import this page. But what we also can do, I click over here. I go to the text, I remove this, and I click over here, and I want to import, let me see, the project title. So there it is. So it's fetching it from WordPress, so I don't have to fill this in manually every time. So now I need to style this, so I go to design. It's now body text. probably. Let me see. Text. If I make this capitals, it becomes capitals. So I make this white, make it bigger. I want to bring it to the center. So now every time we import this page, it will automatically have the title of that project, which saves us a lot of time. Awesome. I think this is fine. Here I want to show a video, so I remove this area, this module. I click over here. I want to search for video. I click on it. Then I go to images, tutorial, portfolio, film, Montana. And I grab this link with sound, copy it. And then I change it over here. First I remove this. Then I click on add video, insert from URL. And I paste the file over here, insert. There it is. Maybe I want to make it a bit smaller, so I can go to spacing. I can say maybe in percentage, I can say 50, 50, 50, 50. Or 100, 100, 100, 100. So it's not too big. And then I say save it. Okay. I exit the Visual Builder. This is how it looks now. We can play the video. And now you see only related projects for this category. So only Montana Lisientes. So if I create another project, new project, and I say Jaylee Cosmetics, I go to the category, or I create a new one and call this web design. Add the new category. I scroll down, search for a featured image, upload files, select files, film. I go to web design. And here it is. This is a website I made. I want to showcase that to my visitors. Set as a featured image. I click on publish and publish. I go to the Divi Builder. And I want to clone a page, the one we just made, from Montana. And what you will see now is that it has the title Jaylee Cosmetics in the same style. How great is this? How great is this? I like it. I click on the plus. I go for a single image. I select it, this one. I want to make it a link to the website, which is https://jaylee.cosmetics.com. Open in a new window. Okay. Save it. And again, when I exit the Visual Builder, you will see only the project Jaylee Cosmetics in the related projects. So that's how it works. I like it. But now we have the portfolio page and we see nothing. So how can we edit this? We can enable the Visual Builder. Then I like to choose an existing page, Jaylee Cosmetics. I click on it. Then I remove this. I remove, let me see, this area and this one and this one. And I remove this. So I click on the plus and I search for filterable portfolio. I want to include all categories. Post, how about 9? And then elements, show the title. Jaylee Cosmetics, show the category. No, show pagination. No. Links fine. It links to the project page. And then I go to design. First, I want to change this to a grid. Like this. Do I want to have an overlay? Yes. Nothing here. Make it transparent. But over here, I want to have this color, but more transparent. Like that. You can have a different icon. Image. We can change this, but all fine. image border if you want to, shadow, change the color. Let's go to the text. I want to make it aligned in the center. Title text, filter text criteria, how should it look? We can make it capitals. We can change the colors. How about this color? We can make it bigger. Spacing. 0. Okay. I check this. Then I go over here to design, sizing. I want to bring the gutter up a bit like that. But what I want to do, I want to make this 100%. And this also totally to the right. Okay. So save. Exit the visual builder. So if we go to the portfolio page, here we are at the blog page. We go to the portfolio page. We see portfolio and then Jaylee Cosmetics, Montana Legendas and the wedding. And if I go over here, I click on it. I go to the portfolio item and then I see all related projects with the category photography. So I will create a few more blog posts and then I will be back with you. So I added more portfolio items. So if I click on the portfolio, it looks like this. And we can filter it based on the category film, photography, web design. One more thing, if I go to photography and I click over here at wedding Daniel and Leah and I edit the project, it says that the category is photography. I can add a new category. I can say the subcategory is wedding. The parent category is photography. Add new. So if I have a really big portfolio, I can also let people search for photography. So if I view the project and I go to the portfolio page, there's another category now, which is wedding. If I do not want to show this, I can enable the visual builder. Go to the module and then I say include only film, photography and web design and not the wedding. Save it. Exit the visual builder. What I do not like is that there are four columns and it seems that you cannot change that, but we can make use of CSS. So if I search for this is how I work, when I see that something doesn't work or doesn't work the way I want it to be, I go and search for Divi show three rows in filterable portfolio. And then I find this page, diviplugins.com, and they come with a solution. I need to insert this in our CSS. So I copy this whole area. Let me see. Copy it. And but then they say, we add the following class, three column grid to our module. So first, I go to the theme customizer. Go to the additional CSS. And here below, we add this code. Nothing happens, but it's called the three column grid. I click on publish. We need to assign this module to this code. How can we do that? We enable the visual builder. I did not prepare this. I just saw the solution. I thought, let's try it so you can see how I do that. And maybe you can do it for yourself. If you want to add extra features, just Google it. So advanced CSS and classes. It is a class. We need to get rid of this. And now it looks like this. So I want to take a look at the green area, the row, and maybe the design can be in sizing 90. Save it. Exit the visual builder. And now it looks like that, which looks better in my opinion. If I want to remove the gutter, I can enable the visual builder or I go to the row and make it 80%. So there's less space between them, or I say the gutter should go to 1. Save it. exit the Visual Builder, and this is how it looks now. I like it. What I want to do now, I want to show this on our homepage. So I go to the homepage, I enable the Visual Builder, I scroll down, I click on the plus, regular, one row. I want to have a portfolio without filters. Show 3, or know what, 4 posts of all categories. I go to design, I make it a grid. I go to content, it's fine, elements, show the title, yes, show the category, no, show pagination, no. Okay, then I go to this area, design, sizing, 1, and I change this to 90. Then I want to add a title, I click on the plus, I go for a text, and I say latest projects, or let me see if I find the title over here, this one. Duplicate it, command minus. I drag it down. I use the arrows on my keyboard. It's not working perfectly, but we're getting there. I release it. Then I drag it down again. And then I drag it down again. And now we are there. And now I want to drag it up. Perfect. Command plus. Let me see. I remove this. And here I say latest projects. Okay. I want to thank you for watching this tutorial. I hope you'll learn a ton of stuff and you will be really successful in every area of your life. I hope you have a great day and you will see me in the next video. Feel free to like this video and subscribe for more upcoming videos. Bye bye.